Hello, friends. It is good to be with you again, even if it is only in this format. I hope to bring you a message each Sunday and starting this week incorporate some music and prayer time. We will pause for an offering and I hope you will take time to prepare an offering you can send to the church. More instructions on that later. By way of announcements, we are still on safe at home order and we'll probably go into April, so the church is closed until further notice. I'm still available by phone or email or text should you need prayer or want some conversation. We have been continuing confirmation and Bible study using Zoom or teleconferencing, and that seems to be working well. Once again, praise God for the technology that we have that allow us to continue to be the church. I want to encourage you to call one another and to drop cards or notes in the mail so that you can keep in touch. It looks like we'll be doing virtual church during Holy Week. Right now I am looking at doing a live YouTube event for Holy Thursday. During Holy Thursday, our center is around the Lord's Supper and communion and the time the disciples had together with Jesus. We cannot do that in person this time, so I am thinking about doing this YouTube event where it will be live and where we can all share together in communion in our own homes, but yet together via this technology. So in preparation for that, I encourage you to have some sort of juice and bread at home, and I will give more instructions about this later on, but if you could have those handy, it doesn't necessarily have to be grape juice if that's hard to come by. Give me another kind of juice and that will work for this purpose. So as I said, more information on this later. Let's prepare to pray together for our opening. Let us pray. Out of the depths, I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits, and in his word I hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than those who watch for the morning. Amen. So I wanted to do some music, and I've got Pastor Lisa here. She's going to help me out. So let me get that set up here real quick here so we can all share in the words. There we go. Let's try that. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I love to sing your praises.
Praises.
I'm so glad you're in my life.
In my life.
You came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross. My debt to pay from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high.
And oh, these are the days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sorrow. To be out of voice in the desert crying, preparing the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, hear a jubilee. Now will fight until salvation comes. These are the days of Ezekiel. The dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding the temple of prayer. And these are the days of the harvest. The fields are as white in the world. Declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice, hear a jubilee. Out of Zion till salvation comes. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, hear a jubilee. Now desire till salvation comes.
Oh, it was nice to sing a little bit and hear some music. I hope you enjoyed that part of it as well and could sing along a little bit. Let us do our scripture readings at this point. Our first scripture reading is from Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 11 through 14. Then he said to me, "Mortal, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say, our bones are dried up and our hope is lost. We are cut off completely. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord God, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people, and I will bring you back to the land of Israel. And you shall know that I am the Lord, and when I open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people, I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live, and I will place you on your own soil. Then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken and will act, says the Lord." And then our New Testament reading is from John chapter 11, verses 25 through 27, and then we will skip up to verses 40 and 41. Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live, and everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone, and Jesus looked upward and said, "Father, I thank you for having heard me." So this week we're going to be talking about the story of Lazarus. This is a 45-verse story, so instead of reading all the verses, I thought we would maybe just review a little bit of the story. The gospel passage tells the story of when Jesus was together with his disciples, and they were up in the northern part of Israel, or up in the Galilee area, and they received word that they received word from Mary and Martha that their brother Lazarus was sick, and Jesus delayed. He's kind of stuck around and stayed where he was, said to his disciples, it's going to be okay, all is going to be okay. And then after 2 days, Jesus says, let's head down to Judea again. And the disciples were a little disturbed at that thought, basically reminding him, you remember what happened the last time we went down there, Jesus, they didn't like you there. They thought your message was a threat and they are trying to kill you. And Jesus says, it's all going to be okay. Lazarus is sleeping and I am going down to wake him up. The disciples still don't get it. Let him sleep, they said. Then Jesus explained that Lazarus was actually dead and he would go and raise him up so that they would believe. But then Thomas, you remember Thomas, sometimes he's called Doubting Thomas. He says, yeah, let's all go down together and we can die together. That shows loyalty, but still a lack of understanding. I think about the human capacity to be somewhat fatalistic about the future. There are some of us who look at the glass half empty, and then there's others who look at the glass half full. Which kind of person is more fun to be around? The glass half full person often helps us to remember that hope exists. They can actually be faith strengtheners. The disciples don't show a lot of faith in what Jesus can do or what he is about in this circumstance. But we shouldn't be too hard on them. We struggle with the same thing. I have a young friend in the church who always seems to have a glass half full spirit about her. She is only 9 years old, but I hope someday that she grows up to be a pastor because I want to attend her church. I want to be a part of that church with a leader who has a can-do attitude and will ignite the church to do wonderful things for the glory of God. We need leaders in the church like that. So the disciples and Jesus, they decide to head on down to Bethany in Judea and see Mary and Martha. Actually, Martha first, so the first one they encountered. Martha was grieving because Lazarus was dead 4 days. I imagine maybe a little perturbed at Jesus because she believed Jesus could have kept Lazarus from dying. Again, Jesus says, it will be all right. Just continue believing. He was saying that you are not forgotten. God is with you. You will be surprised by what God can do and what God will do. Word got to Mary that Jesus was there, so she went right away from where she was to where he was. The people who were there to help Mary and Martha grieve and to support them during this time saw her leave suddenly and decided to follow. So now there's a small crowd that came out and followed them. They all gathered at the tomb of Lazarus, and Jesus commanded them to roll the stone away. And call Lazarus out. Lazarus did come out. He was raised from the dead and several people saw it. Nothing like a miracle to make you believe. We don't have the benefit of walking around with Jesus to help us with our doubts or our fatalism. We have to rely on faith. Faith can be a tricky thing, balancing what we think we know and what we believe. It's true, Jesus doesn't walk around in human form anymore, but Jesus is still with us. God is still with us. We see him in the people who God provides to intervene in our lives. I like the old story about the man who was caught in a massive flood. He was on top of the roof and the water was rising. He prayed, God, I know you can save me. You can get me off this roof and get me to safety. Shortly after he prayed, some men came by in a boat and they called out to him, come on, jump in our boat and we will take you to safety. But the man says, no, thank you. It's all right. God is going to get me off this roof and to safety, and I'm waiting on God. In a little while, a helicopter came and through the loudspeakers called out to the man and said to him that they would rescue him. He should grab the ladder they were lowering down. He called back and said, no, that was not necessary. God would save him. After a while, the water was rising and rising, and the man called out to God again, God, why haven't you come to save me? I know you can. A voice from heaven called out to him, I sent you a boat and a helicopter. What more do you want? God sometimes provides what God does, provide in many ways that we may not attribute as coming from God. And at times we have trouble seeing past our own pessimistic view of things, that we miss seeing God working in our lives and in the lives of others. Martha and the disciples struggled to really believe that good was going to come out of their situation. but Jesus, who loved them all, came through. I am acquainted with a man who was homeless for 12 years. He is not homeless anymore. We had the chance to discuss this a little bit, and he was telling me about one time as he was homeless, he was visited by angels. They came and told him that he could get some assistance that would help him out of his homelessness. They were concerned about him. He was getting a bit older, and there were some possibilities, these angels told him. He kind of ignored them and they left. Later, he was visited by angels again, and they gave him that same message. This happened repeated times until finally he decided to do as they suggested so that they would stop bothering him. At first, as I was talking with him in this conversation, I thought maybe he was talking about a vision of angels or some sort of apparitions. It's interesting when you talk to him, that's easy to get to that idea. But what I found out that he was really talking about were Street Angels of Milwaukee, which is an outreach program to the homeless. They were volunteers. My friend then got the help he needed and has been in his own apartment for several years now, all because God's angels visited him. God does miracles. The timing and the way isn't always in line with how we think God should do things. With the eyes of faith, we will see Jesus still doing miracles for God's glory. Let's watch and see what he does next. Amen. We're going to move into our prayer time now. And let's sing together, Lord, listen to your children praying. Lord, listen to your children praying. Lord, send your spirit in this place. Lord, listen to your children praying. Send us love, send us power, send us grace. Let's sing that again. Lord, listen to your children praying. Lord, send your spirit in this place. Lord, listen to your children praying. Send us love, send us power, send us grace. As we begin our prayer time, I want to invite you to send prayers to my email, and we will include them at next Sunday's service. Because this is a public channel, I will be very generic and not use names. But God knows, and God knows your prayers, and they will be honored. Also, if you have joy, send those too. We all need to hear about God working in and among us. Let us pray. Lord, we pray for pandemic victims and those who are suffering from this coronavirus. We pray for the frontline medical workers, and we pray that you be with them in their working to help people and help patients, for those who are studying this disease and tactics to work against it. We pray for those who are in government who are charged with making decisions for us. And for those who have had their lives disrupted, the school students, the teachers, the people who are not at work, we lift them up to you and pray for you as well. Pray for them as well. And Lord, we just asked that any prayer requests or things that are resting on people's hearts, we would just ask that you would be with them and lift those prayers. Well, we lift those prayers up at this time to you. Pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. So we're going to do presentations of our offerings. we are going to just kind of talk a little bit about the fact that you can still give your offerings even though you're not here in person. You can mail your offerings to the church at Post Office Box 52, Elmwood, Wisconsin. We have a giving button on our website that is available to you. And I am going to see if I can get the technology to help me show this to you. Here it is. So if this is the homepage of our website, and over at the top, there is an online giving button. And if you click on that and scroll down a little bit, you'll see there are some donate buttons. So you can actually give through that if, besides sending a check, this is another way for you to do it. If you want to do it just a single donation, you don't need a PayPal account. You just click on the donate button. Or if you have a PayPal account, you can set this up as a regular thing. Also, just to let you know, if you are part of the Elmwood Church, we have electronic giving, and a form will be included in the next newsletter that you get, which is coming out very shortly. And you can fill it out and send it to the same post office box, and we can set that up for you. If you have questions about any of the above, please feel free to give me a call. So now let us share in our prayer of dedication. Let us pray. Generous God, you have invited us to set our minds on generosity and to live into the peace of abundant sharing. You have invited us to set our minds on love and to live into the peace of compassionate justice. You have invited us to set our minds on your spirit within us and to live into this peace of profound relationship with others. Receive all that we are and all that we return for your use and make it all a blessing. Amen. Thank you for joining us today. We will have another virtual church service posted for next Sunday. In the meantime, God bless you and keep you. May he make his face shine upon you and give you peace. And in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.